Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Denmer again, and today I'm really excited because I'm gonna continue the videos with the Oculus Quest and also AI. So what I'm gonna be doing is playing behind the scenes, which is a demo that I created in a previous video to actually have a car park itself. This time I'm going to be using the Oculus integration to see if this is going to be actually launching on the Oculus Quest. We're also going to be using the Oculus controller, the A and the B button, to basically change the camera mode. So one of the camera modes are going to be inside, right above the car. The other one is going to be right above the parking lot. And that way we can see, you know, how the cars are parking. We can see it from multiple angles, and we're gonna be able to see that on multiple parking lots. So let's jump into Unity and start looking at it. What I have right now is we can look at the controllers. We can look at the cars parking. You can see how the cars are actually going. I can also press either the A or the B buttons. If we go B, it's going to basically change the parking spot and we can go into another parking spot. Can also do that multiple times. It's basically gonna toggle between all the different parking spots that are currently in the scene. The other thing that I can do, I can press A, and what A is going to do is going to basically take me inside the car, right above the car, and we can see how the cars are actually parking. We can do that again, and we can go to another parking spot. You can see that the cars are all working just fine. And we can go to another car here, we can go to the top, and then we can just look down and see how they park. So what I wanna do next is I wanna show you some of the process that went into creating this. All right guys, so let me show you some of the configuration that I have right now. So I'm using the OVR camera rig with the Oculus integration. So if you're not familiar with that, make sure you watch my videos on the OVR Oculus integration where I go into depth on that. So what I ended up doing is just basically just dragging and dropping that component. You can find that component under project. You can either use the OVR camera rig or you can use the OVR player controller if you like and just change the physics to zero. But that's the one that I use, and then I just basically just drag it and drop it here. The other thing that I also wanted to do is just, you know, bring in the actual controller so we could see the prefab. And that's what you see right here. That's the controller that I had on the left hand and also the right hand. The other thing that I wanted to also find out is if I could change the camera view, right? So we want to, on some cases, we want to be right on, above the car. On another case, we want to be right, you know, right on the top of the parking spot so we can see all the different cars. So how did I handle that? So I'm just gonna show you how that works. So I have this car manager that handles that. It has a reference to the OVR camera rig, and that OVR camera rig is the one that I'm using to, you know, as the camera. So if you go inside this, you're gonna see that this has all the different cameras that are needed for the VR component. So what I wanted to do is just, you know, place different components where the camera can actually go. So if we go into this first one and you go inside, you're gonna know that there's a camera view here. There's also another camera view on this other parking lot. There's also another one on this another parking lot. So what I'm basically using is just doing a toggle and saying, okay, I'm gonna change the position every time the user presses the A button or the B button on the controller and just change the index of the selected camera view. The other thing that I wanted to do is I wanted to be right, you know, inside the car. And I shouldn't say inside, but right above it, right here, so that we could actually see how the car actually parks. And if we go into the prefab, I can show you how that is set up. So the camera view is going to be right here, and I can change that if I wanted to be here, or if I wanted to change it back, then, you know, that's going to be the position that we put the camera, the OVR camera rig. The other one that I have is also one inside of the car agent. And if I go inside of the car agent, it's going to be right above here. We can also put it inside if we wanted to and just make these windows transparent. I just ended up putting it right there. That way we didn't have any objects on the way and it was actually easier to see. And if we go into the parking lot area and we go into the script, you're gonna know that I have a script that is handling the area itself. So the area itself has a reference to the camera view and also a reference to the one to the camera view and one to the car view. And I just have properties so that I can access those two. So if you go here, you're gonna see that this one has a reference to the camera view and then this car view has a reference to the car view. That way I know which, you know, where I'm gonna be putting the actual OVR camera rig when that user is selecting, you know, the different modes. So if we go back here and we close out of this one, I'm gonna show you how the actual manager works. If we go into the files, and let me go ahead and scroll down to my scripts. And I have this car manager that handles that, and I'm going to go ahead and close this so that this is out of the way. We have more real estate. And one of the things that I did in here is I just created a car manager that handles that. So one of them is going to be a reference, is gonna be the game object, which is going to be the camera component. That's going to be the camera component that I have in here, and that could be basically anything. If you just want a real camera, you can just do that, or if you want to use the OVR camera rig, you can do that. For VR, we're going to be using the OVR camera rig, so that's going to be tracking the reference to that. And then I just have a reference to all the different car areas, and if we go here to the car manager, you're going to know that I have, you know, a car area, and it's just referencing each one of these. The reason for that is because I want to change the camera, where the camera is going to be, and this is just a simple implementation just to test that ML agent is going to work. And then you just have a selected index that is an integer, is initialized to zero. And then on the update method, I'm just using the OVR input, and I'm calling the getUp method, and if I'm pressing the button B on the controller, I'm going to be moving the camera. If I'm pressing the button A, I'm going to be moving the camera as well. But in this one, I have a parameter that is a default parameter, and the default parameter of this value, it's going to be set to true. So anytime somebody calls this move camera method, it's going, and you don't pass parameters, it's basically going to say, okay, by default, I'm going to be using the camera view, which is going to be the camera view that is right here, right? So if we go back here, I'm going to say, okay, if the selected index is the max, then I'm going to reset it to zero. That way, if we get to the last one, I can just go back to this location. And then we're going to be just recycling through that. Just going to say selected index is one, so this is going to be the camera view. It's going to be, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on until you get to the end. So that's what I'm doing here, just resetting it to zero so that we can go back to the beginning. And then I just say, okay, if the user wants to go to the camera view because they actually selected the B button, then I'm going to be, you know, setting the location of the camera to be the location of the camera view. Otherwise, I'm just going to be doing the car view. That means that they press the A button, so the user wants to go to be right above the car. That way we can see, you know, how the car is currently parking. And then I'm just initializing just, you know, the local position so that we don't have any offsets, and also the local rotation, because if the car is moving right here and, you know, it's going to change the rotation, I want to make sure the camera is, it's the rotation is set back to zero, and I'm just incrementing the index. So that's what that part is. The other implementation that I had in here is just the same implementation that I had before, which is the implementation that I show you on the self-parking example. So if I go here and I were to play, let me go ahead and mute it, make sure that it's muted, and I were to hit play, it's going to work just like it did before. And you can use this for, you know, if you're doing Android development, if you're using PC development, then this is going to work. You guys can see how that is currently working. Let's go ahead and hit pause and then play again. And we can see how the cars are currently parking. So I'm going to go back to the main menu. So the key here is that I wanted to show you this was going to work on the Oculus Quest. So let me show you that. I'm going to be running this on the Oculus Quest. We're going to be deploying it. And I'm going to show you a video of how that works. All right, guys, so before I show you the results of the deployment to the Oculus Quest, I want to show you a couple of settings that you need to make sure to have. So make sure you change it to Android, of course, because we're going to be pushing to the Oculus Quest. And also the scene that I am building, it's added to the scenes in here. I'm also going to player settings. If we go into player settings, the other changes that I had to do is I changed the minimum API level to API level 23. The target API level, I changed it to the highest install, and things just seem to work just fine. And then the last thing is you need to install the Oculus plugin. So go into XR plugin management and then look at the Oculus, you know, the Oculus plugin, and make sure that it's checked. If it's not checked, it's not going to work. And on the Oculus options, I have multipass, focus aware, and also V2 signing quest enable. The other thing that I wanted to mention is I'm using Unity 2019.4.9F1. Make sure that you use that version. I'm also going to be checking this into GitHub so you guys can test it. So let me go ahead and show you the results of running this on my Oculus Quest. And I'm just going to go ahead and maximize this, and you guys can see it. And you can see how the car is parking, and also the controllers are working. And I'm basically toggling between the views. Here's the top view. And I can see how the cars are parking. Can also look down, and at this point, yeah, I'm inside of the car. It's actually right above the car, and you can see how everything just works. And that car keeps spinning, and it looks like it didn't make it. This one is doing okay, and that one made it. So green means that it made it, red means that it didn't make it. So that's honestly everything that I wanted to show you guys. If you guys have any questions, please let me know.